Hi everyone, welcome. I'm Esther from EckhartYoga.com. This is a short kind of part of a longer class that's called More Love for Yourself that you can find on the website, but you can also do this by itself. And it is really great to help open your shoulders in a different way than you're used to. So it's quite cool. Okay, so let's start with placing the feet about hip width, or let's just say place them somewhere where you feel really grounded and connected and supported. And then just begin by rolling the shoulders back. Just get some energy flowing in to the shoulders before we make the exercise a little bit more difficult, and then roll them the other way. Okay, and then inhale, take your arms sidewards, and exhale, right elbow underneath the left. And you can either bring the back of the palms together or the palms themselves. And then you just kind of roll around. So lower body stable, and you just circle the upper body three times. One way. And you can circle into a forward bend and into a back bend when you go back, and circle the other way. Your feet feel grounded. Your navel is drawn into the spine a bit and up to support the upper body to be flexible and movable. Okay, come back to center. Inhale, arms out. Exhale, now your right elbow on top. And we do the same thing. So the lower body supports the movement in the upper body. So for some people, the toes will be pointing forward, the feet will be pointing straight forward. For other people, in my case, my feet are turning out a little bit to give myself more support. It's a really all personal. Okay, and release. Right, and then come to the top of your mat. Inhale, take your arms out and up. Reach long through the spine, feet grounded, fingertips reaching up. And then exhale, knees bent, folding from the hips. Come down. Inhale, half lift. And exhale, step back into a downward dog. Just for a moment, move around here to ease your body into the pose. And then as you're inhaling next, you can bring the feet a little closer together and lift the right leg up behind. And exhale, step it through. And then bring the back heel down. Press your right knee into your right arm. Keep the left hip facing forward, look forward. Even though you may be used to opening up, inhale, take your left arm up, but we're not opening the hip, okay? You're opening the side body, but not the hip. And exhale, turn the palm away from you and place your hand on your lower back or even a little bit towards the hip. Keep looking forward, and now bring the weight into your right foot and become light on the fingertips. So my right arm is now hovering. Inhale. And exhale, navel to spine, hip stays forward. Okay, step back, downward dog. And we do the other side. Inhale, lift left. Exhale, step through. Back heel down. Press your left knee a little bit into the left arm. Inhale, take your right arm up. Keep your right hip facing forward. Keep looking forward. Exhale, turn the palm away. And place your hand on the lower back or towards the left hip. Once you're here, weight in both feet and start hovering, becoming light. Push the floor away, open the chest. Right hip stays moving towards the front of the mat. And exhale, both hands down. Step back, downward dog. Inhale, gently come to plank. And exhale to the floor. Inhale, take a cobra. Just for a moment to open up, shift around a little bit. And exhale, come back down on all fours. On all fours, turn the palms around. So the fingers are pointing towards the knees. You just do cat-cow. So on the exhalation, round your spine. And on the inhalation, come into your back bend. Opening the chest. And again, rounding the spine. Opening the chest. And then from here, tuck the toes under, lift your knees up a little bit and step your right foot on your right hand. Your heel will point in a little, your toes are point out a little. And then walk your left leg back and bring the heel down. See if you can press your knee into your right arm. And then we do the same thing. Left hip stays forward. Take your right arm up to the ceiling. Look forward and over the right shoulder a bit. So you look away and over the right shoulder. So not to the floor. Breathe, press your leg into your arm into your leg. Your feet ground, inhale. And exhale, both hands down. Release and back to downward dog. Come back to the floor with your knees. Turn your palms again. We do the other side. Tuck the toes, lift the knees, and step your left foot on your left hand. Walk the right foot back, heel to the floor. Stay here. See if you can have your knee and your upper arm connected. And then keeping the hip facing forward like before, take your right arm up, turn the palm, and bring it on your back or there. Actually, no, leave it up and then look in front of you. So keep the arm up and then look over the left shoulder. Press your arm into your knee into your arm. Open up, but the hip stays forward and look away and over the left shoulder. Inhale and exhale, both hands back to the floor and step back, downward dog. Deep breath in, lift the heels. And a relaxing breath out, lower the heels to the floor. Inhale and exhale, knees down, come and sit. So this was just, from here you can move into some more binding poses if you like, if you know what to do, and or any other type of more work shoulder opening. But this in itself, you can already feel how this has opened the shoulders and opened the chest. And if you want more, the whole build-up of the class and also the cool-down, again, go over to eckhartyoga.com and find the class More Love to Yourself, but it will be in the description. Thank you so much for joining me, and I hope this already make you feel more open and expansive.